If you ask anything of the Father in my name, he will give it to you. Dear parishioners, we are here today apart from the men of the world. We have a different goal to be obtained. And many people think we're strange for living the way we do, following the commandments of God, the commandments of the church. And maybe even our own family members don't agree with us, don't agree with our position. This always leads me to think, why me? How can I come to this? I know that they're much smarter than myself. Why can't they see it? So all of us here come from different paths. Maybe we were always traditional, or maybe we had to go the full gauntlet of conversion. Coming from the Novus Ordo, or even atheism, some people have come to tradition from that. But the common denominator is we're seeking the truth. We've sought the truth. Not only that, we've cooperated with grace because it's the grace of God. Because, as I said, some of my family members are much smarter than I am. There's many intellectuals in the world who are atheists. But God gives us the grace to see the truth, and we've cooperated with that grace. We've come a long way, even if we've always been traditional Catholics. Make our own progress, our own battle. And so we're here, but it's not over. The battle is not over for our souls. It seemed to be a common misconception that when a young man entered the seminary, that now he begins to float because he's so holy. No, there's still battle, there's still progress to be made. And so it is with us, even though we've come to religion, it's not finished for us. Because the reality is, perhaps for us, depending on where we are, it may just be the beginning. Today may be our beginning. As we wake up to the realization that there is a battle for our souls, that we do have to try to do these things, pray the rosary, attend Mass properly, every instant, to overcome ourselves. But we're here today, we've made it, and we've persevered, but what now? Now that we've heard the truth and sought it out, be doers of the word. Doers. Doers of what? Doers of the word. The word. What word? Well, if we were to sum up the gospel, it would be the greatest commandment of God. Love the Lord thy God with thy whole heart, with thy whole soul, and with thy whole mind. And love thy neighbor as thyself. And as we must be doers, this love must be an action, an active thing, not sitting idle. A positive living of the faith. And this is especially by our intention, because we go through actions every day. All these things, whether you eat or drink, do all for the love of God. You can elevate everything you do. Tie your shoes. This was the little way of Saint Therese. So we need to have this intention, but how can we keep it with the world being so backwards and godless? Because we're in it every day and we see the example of these pagan people that have no idea of God. So how can we remain in this mindset that we're living for the love of God? We need to pray. We know it's His grace we need to overcome the distraction of the world. Our Lord says, without me, you can do nothing. But also, as we read today, ask anything of the Father in my name, and he will give it to you. Strength to persevere. Conversion of our relatives. But we need to be doers. And so not just pray and wait for the grace to come by a miracle and write everything. No, we need to be active. We have to live Catholic lives. We have to promote Catholic atmospheres with each other. Guarding our tongues and watching what we say. Not for fear of human respect, but for the love of God. Because we remember the truth that we heard and sought to live. The truth of the gospel. Let us ever study this. Have the gospel before our minds daily. And so we need to raise our minds and hearts to God each day. Beginning with a morning offering. And ending with an examination of conscience. And if we perfected these two exercises, I think we could make great progress in the spiritual life. And they don't take long. Maybe 15 minutes. That would be a very long examination of conscience. And so we need to have a habit of this. That we continually live in the spirit of Catholicism. And so that we instill these habits into our children. So we may foster vocations to continue the life of the faith. As our children are the future of the church. It's very important that they love the faith. So it's very important that they practice it every day. That it becomes a part of them. That they know our faith is true. It's not something that we do, that we just do or believe. It's true whether we believe it or not. Whether we're a part of it or not. But we know it's true. And so we pray in Jesus' name. For he is the truth. He is what we seek. Union with him. To know God more. To love God more. And unless we end up in heaven, what good is this life? What point is there to this life? So be doers of the word through prayer and example, making everything you do an action for the love of God. Making everything you do a prayer by doing it for the love of God. Be a doer by example, by being an example for everyone we meet, whether it's people in the world or even fellow Catholics. We need to strengthen each other by our examples so we can remember, especially for our children, but so we can all remember what we're a part of. The faithful, the mystical body of Christ, the true religion revealed by God. May we all continue to live as Catholics in a non-Catholic world, but as this is a grace from God, so we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.